Hello and welcome everybody. Today I'm going to show you how to design fan blades in Fusion 360 using lofts and what I want to call the Emboss trick. Whether you're using it for a compressor project or for replacing a broken rotor of your favorite fan, this method will certainly work for you. So without further ado, let's get started. Today I'm designing a small cooling fan. I'm starting by sketching the inner and outer diameters on the top plane. I choose a hub diameter of 20 mm and an outer diameter of 80 mm. I will need solid bodies later, so I extrude the two circles I've just sketched into new cylindrical bodies. As I will need some margin for trimming in the end, I offset the faces. The outer cylinder gets offset by positive 1 mm on every face. Here I have to choose new offset. The inner cylinder gets offset slightly differently. The top and bottom faces get offset by positive 1 mm, just like the larger body. In contrast, I offset the cylindrical face by negative 1 mm, so that the diameter gets smaller. Then I create an offset plane for sketching the blade profiles. I first sketch the inner blade profile and start by projecting the relevant lines from the body. I want to define my blade profile by its leading angle of attack and its trailing angle of attack. So first, I create auxiliary lines at those angles. Fusion's blend curves feature is the easiest way of creating a smooth profile between points, so I'm using it here. For the next step to work, I have to have a closed profile, so I add two more lines. I repeat the same process by sketching the outer blade profile on the same plane. While I'm sketching, feel free to like and subscribe, and if you have any feedback, questions or suggestions for future videos, please let me know in the comments. Now I can use the emboss feature to effectively wrap my blade profiles around the cylinders. I use the inner blade profile as sketch profile and the inner cylinder's face as face. I prefer the deboss option, but one could also work with emboss. The depth value is not really important, it should just be large enough so that you do not create two small faces. As I will only need one curve of the body, I deconstruct it after switching to the Surface tab. I select Faces and hit Remove on the keyboard until only the outermost cylindrical face of the body remains. Notice that the solid body has now become a surface body in the model tree on the left. I repeat the same process for the larger cylinder. First, I emboss the outer blade profile onto the cylinder, then I delete the unnecessary faces. I want to continue by sketching the remaining edges of the blade. I start with the leading edge of the blade. I will need a plane to sketch on, so I add an offset plane based on one upper point of the cylindrical faces. I first project the relevant corner points into my sketch. These points technically already lie on the sketch plane, still I have to project them before I can use them in the sketch. Then I want to connect them with a sketch line. For simplicity, here I choose connecting them using an arc. I could, of course, again use connect curves or make use of a spline. I repeat the same process for the trailing edge of the blade. I first create an offset plane, then I sketch an arc on this plane based on the projected corner points. Now I can finally create the actual blade face. I select loft from the surface tab. As profiles, I choose the edges of the cylindrical faces. As guide rails, I use the edges I have just sketched. I don't need the cylindrical faces anymore, so I can remove them. Now I can make the blade solid by thickening the face. I switch to the solid tab, choose thicken and enter a thickness value of 1 mm and symmetric as direction. Now I want to trim the blade. For that I create a hollow cylinder based on the very first sketch. I choose intersect in order to trim my blade body. I want to have more than one blade, of course, so I create the circular pattern. As axis, I choose the C-axis and do a full pattern of 6 blades. Now it's finally time to create the hub and bring it all together. This again is just an extrusion based on the very first sketch. I can choose Join to automatically join all blades to the hub. My fan is finished now, but of course I could go back to the sketches and optimize my design. I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Feel free to share your results. If you have any questions or suggestions, let me know in the comments. Have a great time designing and prototyping.